We are here to discuss the relationship between ICT for development and ICT for disaster mitigation and management. I was giving a background of how the initiative was born and also what has happened between the first board and the establishment of the new board and the emerging challenges in terms of new technologies and how we could and the international community embrace that technology. So I was looking at three basic technologies. One is Internet of Things, machine-to-machine communication, and also looking at big data and the opportunities that come with that, particularly to address business, but also epidemics when they do raise their ugly head. And also looking at artificial intelligence, because we believe that in the near future there will be convergence of those three technologies. And we can mobilize those and harness them for attaining the 2030 development agenda. The beauty of it is that we have got people who come from all walks of life. We have professors who are going to contribute to capacity building. We have got ministers in terms of policy. We have got regulators in terms of making sure the regulatory framework is in place. And you know that we are implementing the Tampere Convention, which seeks to break regulatory barriers in terms of cross-border movement of telecommunications resources when disasters do strike. We also have people who have got a very strong financial background, legal background, and all those will be contributing, because in the future we are going to look at establishing a standby fund, which is going to be for financing operations when disasters strike. But most importantly also, we have got to look at how we can mobilize populations and volunteers to come and assist their neighbors when disasters do break. But again, we have to focus mostly on establishing an enabling environment to make sure the operations are smooth and we can save people's lives in real time. This time, we are building from plan to action. In the first board, we were looking at how we could establish a framework. Now we are looking at implementing concrete measurable projects which are based on key performance indicators in a results-based management framework. So we would like to see the results. We would like to see the relationship between the work that we do in the Telecommunication Development Bureau and that of the Sustainable Development Model, and make sure that there is no contradiction but complementarity in the process.